It's a big win for India in the Kulbhushan Jadhav case. Exactly 800 days after India moved the International Court of Justice, the government has managed to secure a verdict in its favour. The verdict has major ramifications for Pakistan. The 16-judge bench at the International Court of Justice ruled overwhelmingly in India's favour, 15-1. Judge Tasadduq Hussain Jilani, the ad hoc judge appointed to ensure Pakistan's representation on the bench, was the only dissenter, not surprisingly. Here are the five major takeaways from the verdict. One, Pakistan violated the Vienna Convention. Even though Pakistan filed an espionage case against Kulbhushan Jadhav, he has the rights under the international law. This means that Kulbhushan Jadhav has the right to consular access. India had requested access to Jadhav not once, not twice, but 16 times. Pakistan denied all of those requests. 1-6. The military court in Pakistan had issued a death sentence. The International Court of Justice has put a stay on that. No death sentence for Jadhav just yet. The trial conducted against Jadhav in Pakistan is not fair. The court said it in so many words. The International Court has specifically asked Pakistan to ensure a free trial in this case. This includes allowing Jadhav to be represented by a lawyer of his choice. These are basic rights that he was denied. The International Court of Justice also said that Jadhav must be given consular access without delay.
The court is of the view that Pakistan is under an obligation to cease those acts and to comply fully with its obligations under Article 36 of the Vienna Convention. Consequently, Pakistan must inform Mr. Jadhav without further delay of his rights under Article 36, paragraph 1b, and allow Indian consular officers to have access to him and to arrange for his legal representation as provided by Article 36, paragraph 1a and c.
Essentially, this verdict means that Pakistan's so-called trial against Kulbhushan Jadhav was a sham. Pakistan has been asked to review and reconsider the judgment in the Jadhav case. India had also sought annulment of the verdict by the military court and the release of Kulbhushan Jadhav. The judges did not agree to that. They said they do not have the jurisdiction to rule on this. The judgment makes it very clear. Pakistan violated international law and basic human rights in the Jadhav case. Repeatedly, the verdict emphasizes that principles of a fair trial must be followed. India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi has welcomed the verdict. In a tweet, he said, and I'm quoting, "We welcome today's verdict in the International Court of Justice. Truth and justice have prevailed. Congratulations to the ICJ for a verdict based on extensive study of facts. I'm sure Kulbhushan Jadhav will get justice. Our government will always work for the safety and welfare of every Indian."
We welcome the judgment delivered just now by the International Court of Justice in The Hague in favour of India in the case relating to Sri Kulbhushan Jadhav. The court, by a vote of 15-1, has upheld India's claim that Pakistan is in egregious violation of the Vienna Convention on Consular Relations 1963 on several counts. We also appreciate the direction by the International Court of Justice that Pakistan should review and reconsider the conviction and sentence given to Sri Jadhav by the Pakistani military court. We note that the court has directed that Pakistan is under an obligation to inform Sri Jadhav without further delay of his rights and to provide Indian consular officers access to him in accordance with the Vienna Convention. We expect Pakistan to implement the directive immediately. This landmark judgment validates India's position on this matter fully. We will continue to work vigorously for Sri Kulbhushan Jadhav's early release and return to India.